नित्यानंदेश्वर महासदाशिव समारंभां नित्यानंदेश्वरी पराशक्तिमध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्तां वंदे गुरुपरंपरा। I welcome you all with my love and respects. I welcome every one of you sitting with us all over the world in hundreds of centers, all the Sarvajnapeetha Yajamans, Shri Mahans, Mahans, Tanidhar, Kotari, visitors, viewers, sitting with us all over the world. I welcome every one of you with my love and respects. I'll expand on physics of fortune, chemistry of fortune, biology of fortune. Listen. Physics of fortune, chemistry of fortune, biology of fortune. So you can attract fortune. First thing, do not ever equate currency to your fortune. We should be very clear, currency is not equivalent to your fortune. Understand fortune in real sense, then you can really see where you are and you can really understand where you want to be. Please understand, if you believe currency equivalent to fortune, you are part of all the violence and wars happening on the planet Earth. If you believe currency is fortune, you are also part of this big game. Your ignorance and illusion can not only cause damages to you, it can cause damage to everyone, to the world. Understand? For every idea you spend your time, you are voting for it to live long. If you are spending your time for the concept called currency, you are voting it to live long. Liberating your thinking from the enforced Maya matrix that currency is equivalent to your fortune. It's actually enforced on you. Liberating yourself from that enforcement, freeing yourself from that Maya matrix, thought current prison, is the first step for attracting fortune. Understand, I am not interested in social revolution and rebel. No, I am not talking about all these great truths to make you guys rebels. I am interested in giving a breakthrough to your consciousness. I am coming back to my concern again and again. From monkey to man, we took only million years. But it's already 10 million years. What's going on? Why the man to Superman is not happening? Even naturally, without your so-called civilization, it should have happened. So many bondages and prisoning ideas are put on you, which is not letting you to have superconscious breakthrough. Legitimized possessiveness is the concept of nation. Understand? If you individually feel possessive about a land, it looks like something is not right. Anything which suffocates you and makes others feel suffocated by you is not the flow of life. It is not natural flow of life. It is not yama. It is not dharma. When an individual feels, I think it's not right, what I am doing, this possessiveness is not right. If he tries to evolve, he would have had a conscious breakthrough. But all the stupid street dogs ganged up and evolved a concept of legitimizing their possessiveness. That is what is called the concept of country, nation. Understand, I am not asking you to rebel against the nation concept, and I am not interested in that. I am telling you only one thing. Liberate yourself. Whatever stops you having conscious breakthrough. Understand owning, not possessing. You need to understand. People ask me, then you also own this land, you also have property. Understand? This adhinam, I own, not possess. If I don't allow any one of you just live like a farmhouse, then I possess. But all my doors are open. Constantly I am asking more and more people to come in. Actually, the moment I declared this place is an adhinam, more footfall, more brand value of this place. Understand? My very declaration of this place is an adhinam means I only own and facilitate for larger number of people to use this place. I only take care that nobody destroys it or abuses it. I own, not possess. Human beings are given this planet Earth to own but not possess. Beautifully Upanishad says, Tyage naika amrutatva manasuhu. Understand, that verse starts very beautifully. Not by wealth, not by the inheritors. Wealth and inheritors are very closely connected. This idea of inheriting. Collapses the whole concept of owning. And makes the whole thing into possessing.
first thing you need to look into the ideas of your fortune. I am not saying don't own currency. All I am trying to tell you, if you believe currency is equivalent to your fortune, you are such a stupid fellow. Maybe you are worthy of currency, but not fortune. Stupid are those who are worthy of currency, not fortune. Na karmana, not by your actions. Na prajaya, not by your inheritors. Dhanena, not by which can be passed on to others, the possession. It's only by tyaga. Means, listen, here I wanted to tell you the word, the meaning of the word tyaga. Ability to retain your determination in spite of all the complexities and complications a collective mind tries to put you to bind yourself and break you down is tyaga. Determination, chastity to your consciousness. What you feel as you in your source should go on be expanding. Determination to be chased towards your consciousness. And ability to stand strong with that determination is tyaga. Understand? The physics of fortune is tyaga. I tell you, the depth you are able to exhale, you will infuse more life into you. Your ability to infuse life into you is not your ability to inhale, your ability to exhale. So when you are normal, healthy, the practice you need to do is more and more ability to exhale. Normally, give more emphasis on your ability to exhale. Understand, tyaga is ability to stand. Ability to stand. I'm giving you two, three important understandings about the physics of fortune. Understand this, you will really attract fortune. When you are exhausted, tired, don't try to no.
Listen. I'm telling you, least fortunate person, reasonably fortunate person, most fortunate person, if I put them and see what is the difference between physics of this person and this person, nothing but each one's ability for tyaga. If you learn tyaga, for every janma you will carry fortune, I guarantee you. This statement I am making, if you learn tyaga, you will carry fortune for all janmas, not just as a teacher of this attracting fortune class, as Mahasadashiva. I am telling you. It's a reality of the cosmos I am revealing to you. Learn the ability of tyaga. I'll repeat the definition of tyaga. Determination. To stand with integrity to your conscious decisions and conscious conclusions. Even amidst all the complexities and complications, the society's collective unconscious ideas throw on you, that determination is tyaga. Listen carefully. Everyone who lives around you throws their unconscious influence on you. If you don't throw your conscious determination on them, they will be throwing their unconscious influence on you. What about you? Even on me, people try to throw. No, really. Tyaga means determination. So naturally, when you stand with the determination to be integrated to your conscious conclusions and your conscious decisions, instead of the Maya matrix of the so-called society, they will threaten to take away many things from you. Stand with tyaga. I tell you, you will be fortunate.